Hello, everybody. Welcome in. Thank you very much for your patience, of course. It was a little while getting into the game, but we are indeed here. So, Eternal Fire, their map pick starting off on the T side. A lot of utility to work with. I'm liking where this is headed.
Yeah, it looks like Eternal Fire are going to go for what they sort of tried and tested method for many teams on the T-Pistol on Vertigo. Just show some presence early on, then just walk up as a four. And they've got the left side and right side smokes ready and rowing to go if they want to execute onto the A-bomb site itself. And it looks like Movistar Riders are already playing a little bit retake early on here.
Fair amount of tension early on, isn't there? Like you said, they've not played for a while, so really sending the feelers out for this. But indeed, just keeping it simple. Get that bomb down. Nice and open plan. There is no kit available over on that CT side, so they're going to have to get a bit of a step on here with their utility. Now, the big one to watch is Major on the flank. They're somewhat aware, but they just don't have time to hold for him, right? So he's got to find the perfect timing here, and he could end the round single-handedly.
Yeah, and the fact that Eternal Fire planted open as well is so big for them, and Major times that flank to perfection. Finally, there's a player on the bomb, but he's been found, and it's absolute wipeout for Eternal Fire. Great start for them. That's just the perfect execute. Movistar Riders, I've seen them struggle on CT Vertigo in the past. And then playing retake without a kit is already a bit of a questionable start, at least in my opinion. If you're going to play retake on the A-bomb site, I really think you need a kit and a smoke to go for that defuse. But not on this occasion, and Eternal Fire will take those every day of the week.
Righty, force buy-in. Got some deegs. See what the move is here. Early utility, so nothing too crazy early on. The big man, Martinez. New addition.
Yep.
Yet to watch him play live, personally.
Same here.
Obviously, you know, spectated, watched as a fan, but
exactly.
Not casted. It's a different kind of feeling. So we'll see what he's capable of.
Yeah, it's a first for me as well. I didn't actually catch any of the matches in the RMR. I was stacked open qualifier, of course. So many good teams to watch. And now Eternal Fire, after making some presence toward the bottom of A once again, they're going to walk toward B this time. And they're walking in toward Davy G. Flash is primed. Xantaros probably will catch him in the angle here. And yes, just walks up and actually avoids the position that Davy G is holding perfectly. Whether that's by luck or by judgment, who knows? But Xantaros already wants some of these anti-force buy kills. Being aggressive towards CT, Death has no idea. He's up so far. That's two for Xantaros, and with half health left, he's going to make sure he doesn't lose that AK. So it's down to Movistar to save the Force-bought Deagles and Scout into the next round to try again.
Yeah, somewhat anticlimactic so far, at least if you're an Eternal Fire player. Movistar Riders is kind of eating bullets in the noggin, so... Yeah, been a bit of a rough start. Maybe not the way that they'd want to kick off. As said, and listen, guys, keep an eye on those player cams, because it's been a rough few days. And you know, Sponge noted on one of the broadcasts the other day that he saw them in the huddle and everything, and it wasn't the best energy before the game. I think this was maybe their Cloud 9 game or whatever, and they also got a bit ruined in that one.
Mm-hmm.
So you got a lot of factors going into that Cloud 9 game. It's like you're not really expected to win. You probably don't even believe yourself that you're going to win. You've got to be a bit of a realist. You're also not on the hottest form. So it's been a rough few days. But this is the one game where maybe there's EG. We do rip into EG a fair bit, but I would say Movistar Riders are capable there. But this is certainly the game, EU versus EU, players that you know, players that you know you maybe pug against, you might not have played the actual team in a while. This is the one that they should be able to pull out some interference as well. If they take a map off of Eternal Fire, the whole thing's up in the air.
Exactly, absolutely. I mean, as we mentioned beforehand, of course, there'll be lots of new people joining us at every second, so... I'll give you a bit of a relay, of course, on those permutations as we go along throughout the day. There are two ways in which Eternal Fire can qualify for playoffs. That obviously does rely on the other matches going their way as well. Imor, with the Galil, will take first point toward the top of A ramp. It's just pistols now. That's the scout removed from Martinez. And that's going to be probably another easy round for Eternal Fire because they only have these pistols to face. But if they go one by one, that could be a bit scary. Morpoz is going to rip the head off of him, or that's the Galil down, but now it's down to Major and Paz to go up with Mac 10s and maybe eat up these armor supplies.
Yeah, it should be all good from here, to be fair. We'll see. Damage is good. Kill bonus, if anything, going into your rifle rounds, pretty nice, I would argue.
Oh,
nice shot out from Deaths in isolation. Any more than this, and I mean, they can be relatively chuffed with where the damage is at. A lot of damage done, got to get away from that bomb, etc. So there's a chance here, to get some catches. Here we go.
Look at the health.
If they had a kit, the round would be on. Look at this HP. It's just not there. They don't quite know that, but there's really a good chance, yeah, to just pick up a few more. The suicide molly to confirm the kills. And Woxic probably going to go down to the bomb, actually, if he can't get out of here. So
yeah.
Yeah, big damage. Big damage. I think he will fall. Going to get that AK out. Not a bad idea.
Everyone.
They're actually all going to go down. But...
Everyone's gone. The server is empty into the next round. Unfortunate. But yeah, it's Woxic obviously trying to get rid of the AK in case one of those CTs survive and gets a free gun into the next round. But yeah, in the end, everyone goes down. Paz there. It looks a bit silly what he's done to just peek with a molly out. But realistically, that molly guarantees the round either way. They're both so low. If they go for duels, and they could just lose them even to one bullet from a pistol. So, yeah, that absolutely makes certain that round is not in any threat. But as you say, Movistar Riders, with what they had, will be very delighted with their damage. But they're not expecting Imor once again. The professional W holder on this Eternal Fire roster. Just charging up ramp, gets an opening pick, and Xantaras will trade his trader as well. So, 4v3 early on.
What can they do with it? Martinez flashed off, but not making any noise. Have to be very, very careful with a move like this not to go down, right? 4v3 is recoverable, 4v2 less so. And maybe even verging on completely unrecoverable against teams of this caliber. There's the jump across. They've seen him. Oh, there was a little thingy poking out around the corner, but he didn't see it. All the same, Martinez still alive. But he is caught in a pretty bad spot, and he doesn't have any support anymore as that Molotov comes in. So really, really rough here. They're going to try and back him up and just keep control of the site itself. Xantaras is not afraid to take that fight, though. And now Davy G remains, and no longer. Four rounds in a row and a pretty decisive opening rifle round from the Turkish squad.
Yeah, that was so clean as well. With that opening 4v3, they can just then play out the time. I mean, once they know they have the advantage, even if there are all three players around the site, you know, they can just get the utility up and have a pretty clean entry towards the site. And in the end, Martinez had no choice but to try and go for some picks. I mean, if you can bring the round back with two frags, and there's a chance, but that requires going aggressive and couldn't do anything with that. Still, though, Xantaras, again, is looking for some of the ecos as they walk toward mid. Davy G with the Deagle. Needs to be wary of that one. But if you ever want a masterclass on how to swing angles and how to clear angles with good crosshair placement, you've got some great players to watch in the world of Counter-Strike. Watching a Xantaras demo is one you should definitely consider.
Yes, sir. I mean, those peak Xantaras hours as well, we might get back to them, but
yeah,
those Space Soldiers upsets back in the day where he would literally just 35 kills take over a game. And a few performances like that on big as well.
Doesn't even
he is cheeky with it. If he's in the zone, these are the types of rounds as well that are really going to build him up. He does get shut down by Alex, but a couple of nice shots. Yeah, the ego builders, as it were, for Xantaras is really, yeah, really important. He's a pretty momentum-based player. Already 8-2. So, you know, exactly. If nothing stops him, you know, a nice clean rifle round here or whatever, and it could be one of them vintage Xantaras takeovers.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, obviously, as I mentioned before, a lot of people have sort of questioned the performances of Paz on this roster. They've said, we should bring back X-Floud. He's just 10 times better. But realistically, X-Floud would have the same issues, playing some of the same roles. And even though he did very well, of course, in those roles, Paz is not necessarily an eco-hunter on this team. It's always the players like Xantaras, like Immortal, to go for frags, and this time on a gun round, Immortal once again made his way up ramp, and it's actually a carbon copy, can you believe? Exactly the same thing has happened once again on a gun round from Movistar Riders. Immortal charges up, gets an opening pick, Xantaras trades his trader, and I've just had to feel some deja vu.
Yes, always a weird phenomenon. But I don't know. Do you feel like maybe they've read into the mental side of things that we've kind of pushed as a storyline here? I feel like they might have done, because repeating the same round and finding success with it is somewhat of a tilter. And then here's where the change is. They're going to go B, and there's no one there. Movistar Riders are just playing to the tune of Eternal Fire so easily. And
yeah,
with that bomb going down in just a second, you can already see they're moving to save. Like, it's only six rounds, but this is a bit of a masterclass from Eternal Fire so far.
It is, and the T-side start as well. If you get that good T-side start, it's huge to keep the CT economy under wraps. And at the moment, Eternal Fire are already building up that money pretty nicely. Of course, the only round they really lost numbers to was that pistol round, hilariously, for Movistar Riders. They haven't had any progress, really, in a gun round as of yet. And they've got the economy to be absolutely comfortable with at least going hunting for some of these saving players. Especially as there's an AWP still in play as well. I mean, it makes sense to try and remove some of them. But yeah, bomb will explode. It will be a 6-0 start. I expected this, I've got to say. I mean, Movistar Riders have, as we all have spoken about, struggled a little bit in Pro League this season. As we spoke about in the pre-game, probably a combination of losing some Pius and the come down from their ridiculous run at Cologne. I mean, you're not going to get better than a Cologne semi-final in front of a crowd, are you? So it's... I think this is sort of something that I expected from this roster. And as for Eternal Fire, as I said before, they've played so much CS recently. From the Rotterdam Quals to even today beating Mouse online, while in Malta, of course, to try and make it through in that Blast qualifier. So, yeah, this team is certainly on form. And as I mentioned before as well, certainly on form in Vertigo, because they've taken it against Furia and against Liquid in this very tournament. So they're a force to be reckoned with.
Yeah, what do you reckon, very quickly on that, like a question that Sponge posed in a similar scenario when I think it was also Eternal Fire being played a bunch of games. Do you think that's a good thing or a bad thing that they're, just spamming the Counter-Strike?
It depends. I think for this roster, it's a good thing, because I think they have, two new additions. They're not new to the players. I mean, as we mentioned, Paz and Major from the Sangal days, not new to the scene whatsoever. Space Soldier Sangal, they've been around for a while. They had a little break to go to the V-Word game, which we won't discuss. But, it's probably pretty wild that they're playing so many games. But if you've got two new additions like that, I think it really does help you, especially as Major, re-adding him. He is the IGL. So more time with your IGL can only be a good thing.
Well, absolutely. Let's see what this B hit has got in store then. Oh. Pretty open out here. And Immor, man, fearless. And it's exactly what you need from an entry fragger. There's no one there, guys, but they just want to confirm that fact. They're single player holding B. I mean, it is somewhat rare, in fairness. Decent nade damage. Plant coming in. Hot paws up close, but these smokes are really in the way. It's going to be an awkward retake here, isn't it, to be honest? They've got such good positions on that T side, just playing around the bomb, not messing around, not taking any risks. In comes the flash, not good enough. Look at him or go. Oh my goodness. And the return, the counter flash, is way better. So that'll be no kills on the retake coming in for the Movistar Riders side, and Big Man Martinez saving.
Realistically, you would say that 4v5 with the bomb planted on B, you should definitely be saving as a group of four there. But I mean, Movistar Riders have been so locked out early on here. They've probably warmed up all day. And they've already gone cold again, because they've been given no chance to do any fragging whatsoever. Immor's just charging up A, and he's charging through B and getting entries every single time. And that 3k was absolutely ridiculous, wiggling his mouse around like his life depends on it. And to be fair, Eternal Fire's life does depend on it in this match in EPL Season 16. So he's performing when they need him most at the moment.
Can Movistar get on the board before it gets to a dangerous scoreline? That's the big question for me. I mean, seven in a row is already, you would argue, enough to work with, but you can turn this around. Zantarez, leading the charge. They're just looking so good. Even that kill from Davy G is a bit of work without the player even looking at him. Alex is going to go pry in. He loves a move like this. He's going to get the first. Maybe needs a bit more from here, and he'll get it. Beautifully played. Here we are. Back to what we know from Movistar Riders.
Yes.
The smoke is a little a little off, but he knows what he's doing. He's working around it, right? It's all good. Maybe a bit intentional that there's a gap on that left-hand side. I think it is.
Yeah. I think Alex is finally fighting fire with fire against Eternal Fire, which is good to see, because it's about time. He's going to pull out an incendio here. Should probably get caught by Major. There we go. So that's a bit of an error, but he's got his two kills, and that's his work done. WG's on an elevated angle on top of the cone as well, so that's hard to pre-fire. And he will take Woxic. So finally, Movistar have fought their way in, as they say, fighting for ramp a bit more. They were giving Eternal Fire so much space early on there, and they were just walking into it and taking heads every single round. So finally, they've tried to fight for it, and it's going to work out for an opening round unless Major does something ridiculous. The bomb is in the vision of two CTs in Davigi and Death, so there's no way in to get that. So finally, Movistar Riders get their first round, and that's the curse of the 7-1. It always happens no matter what the teams and what the scoreline, it seems.
Yeah, it's kind of the unwritten rules, isn't it, really, I think. But, no, I mean, yeah, there was the clear shift in there. And again, it is that turning point. It is that sort of subconscious just maths in your head. It's like, right, if we go 8-0 down, we have officially lost the half. Even if we recover every single round from here on in. So I think that this leaves the door open, obviously, for them to maybe pull it way back and maybe get the lead themselves. Now, yeah, it's unlikely, you would probably imagine, but not impossible. I think that's the big thing for a lot of teams, especially Movistar Riders right now. They need a bit of hope to cling on to, really.
Exactly. I mean, as I mentioned, really, Movistar Riders, this particular match, they're playing for pride, aren't they, in Pro League this season? That's all they can really play for. And Eternal Fire are playing for quite a lot. And what could be an very unlikely storyline of them making playoffs. As I say, it's a long shot. If they win 2-0, basically we need results to go their way. If they win 2-1, they need results to go their way. So obviously, we'll dig more into detail of that if the situation arises. But first pick goes away of Movistar. WG will get that frag, and the grenade will clear him out of the round. Now, Death's under a lot of pressure on the B defense. Thankfully, though, he has Mopoz in support. Flash will come in. Everyone's very blind. Body blocking in the flash, and Immortal gets the entry. And Xantaros is doing so much damage, but Death's, he holds mouse one and somehow takes Xantaros as well. Two bullets left, but still a 3v2. They're trying to find him, and finally, they have. Bomb can try and go down, but no. Paz has pushed up, and he pushed up with the bomb. So that gives Woxic a big issue, 1v2.
He's onto his preferred AWP. 25 seconds is the big one. He's got to make a move soon, and of course he drops back. That allows Martinez to get to a pretty decent angle, although he's playing mega, mega safe. 10 seconds. There's no way he pulls off both, right? I think that's the big issue here. He's got the bomb. Fake plan. Hello. Okay.
Yeah,
surely, yeah, I was going to say, surely from Bridge you can get away here. I mean, it's a nice idea from Woxic, but from our perspective, I think trying to go for the plant there may well have been the move. Nonetheless, Movistar Riders, two in a row for them now.
Yep, finally getting some frags back in response, of course. But even that one kill from Woxic at the end there is important. I mean, it means that Movistar can't build up that bank. They lost four players. Already they're struggling economically in the next round. WG's going to have to be on a FAMAS again. So, nice attempt from Woxic. I do question what Paz was necessarily doing with the bomb on his back, walking up the railing there. Close CT. Maybe he's trying to get further up than they're expecting, and then one kill, then jump back and plant. But either way, I mean, I think that planting would have been tough, even if he was just hiding behind default. But still, losing the bomb in that position really was the end for Woxic's chances in that round. Early 1-for-1 in round 10. Immor will once again get his one, like he has been doing the whole game so far. But he will be traded by Martinez's AWP this time.
It's a difficult read from here. These are the moments that make the great teams, really, these sort of mid-round calls. And Eternal Fire, you can see prodding and poking in different spots of the map, really. Lot of respect from Movistar Riders. I think they have learned that one pretty early on, but getting the balance of how much respect and how much confidence they need in themselves, that's kind of been the tough thing. They've hit it in the past few.
Yeah.
Where does it keep on going? Attention on both bomb sites. That's kind of what they're after. Split the defense.
Yeah. Anyway, 30 seconds to go. Tunnel 5, and you need to make a decision, and a decision is the A-bomb site. Right now, there is only one player. Now make that two players, make that three players on the defense. So they're going to try and fight Eternal Fire here, mid-execute, and it's working out for them. Davy G gets one with the FAMAS. Once again, the trades are even. So 2v2, 12 seconds to plant the bomb. What does Martinez do to try and deny it? He tries to go for the kills. Paz has to get it down, and he's trying it, but Warbangs can come in to try and prevent it. They're going to run him down. Des gets that one, and Martinez finds Woxic trying to help out Paz on that completely stuck angle. So again, Eternal Fire, they get their progress. This time a little bit too long, though, on trying to get that bomb down.
Getting tough now. Getting tough. Movistar Riders, they're spinning it back. This is the beauty of the LAN, you know. It's really, we always say Counter-Strike never over till it's over. I mean, it just feels way bigger on LAN. Really well read. They didn't even, you know, go too deep with the timeout and everything, so I am loving it. I am loving it. Movistar Riders still the 7-0. This is the thing. You're trying to build them up, and I think we get a bit caught in the wide-eyed, oh, we're doing a bit of Pro League and stuff like this. But you do also have to say that 7 rounds on the T side of your own map pick of Vertigo kind of should be winnable from here.
That's pretty good.
And they've got potential to get way more. So we'll see. We'll see. And there is the falter. Deaths goes down, leaves one very low indeed. Zantara's not going to eat that nade. There is another one on its way, however.
There we go.
And that one will finish him off. Davy G, here we go. Oh. Getting aggressive. Beautiful flash. This is the play. This is the move. He will go down, but he's bought so much time.
Yeah, that was a fantastic grenade and reposition there from Davy G. Fast flick to find Imor. But I think they're going to leave the situation. It was an interesting run boost as well to get Zantara's across that angle, because often players can be holding and you can see legs first. If you're holding a particular position as a CT on top of those stairs. So that's why they flung Zantara's over and it worked out for them. But look where Alex is. They're walking into a ramp and Alex is pushed out all the way down, and he could have a couple of frags on the table. There's one, there goes the bomb, and they line up. Thankfully, Woxic still gets that frag. But now 54 health, 1v2. Has to be sharpish with his run to go and plant the bomb as well. And already they're trying to line up towards CT to go for the retake. Wallbang can come in, maybe attempt it again. We saw it attempted before. Grenade, and then the wallbang. It's a combination that works perfectly. And my little call there comes off. Thanks, Martinez, for making me look smart. Fourth round on the board.
There you go. Clip it and ship it, mate. Already, it might get yourself some karma. But all the same, yeah, it's looking pretty good. Movistar Riders with the big turnaround here. Again, it's four in a row. Still three the gap. Here comes the timeout. Eternal Fire feeling the burn. And they will indeed now make sure that they are no longer feeling it, right? So, difficulty for Movistar Riders ahead. If they can get through this one, then I can see this half looking pretty damn good, because you've got to feel major low money. And, of course, it just isn't built up for Eternal Fire at this point. So, without bomb plants, they're really struggling.
Yeah.
Pretty important round. Pretty important swing round here to indeed even things up as much as Movistar Riders can, or for Eternal Fire to get back on it and get back to extending, you know, this already strong lead.
Yeah, for sure. And I think also that so far in the last, you know, little streak that Movistar have had from 7-0 to 7-4, they've sort of just played more aggressive, simple as that. They were giving Eternal Fire so much respect earlier on. You brought it up yourself. And finally, they've tried to respond with some of their own. And it's been working out for them very well. And even that round, which was, I think, the 7-3, their third in a row, was just a great battle to get back into that sort of go 2-for-2 at ramp. That delayed so much time off the clock. And Tunnel Fire rushed to get the plant, and that was the issue for them. Another 1-for-1 toward ramp early on. Zantara's once again gets an entry. They haven't failed with these entries at all, but just the late rounds have been a bit short in the last few for Eternal Fire, and now the health is a pretty big issue as well. Immor 16, Woxic 27. It's going to be another repeat of Movistar Riders going hunting for information. Three players swinging wide to look for this. I should tell a lie, two players swinging wide looking to look for this, but they'll now know that Eternal Fire have left completely, and they can rotate an extra body over toward mid and B.
Ooh, Martinez missed shot.
Oh no.
He's going to go for the re-peek as well. He's burning now. It will get that smoke in to give him a bit of space here.
Oh, no.
Major's gone through with the bomb, so that's very awkward indeed. Forces the hand. Look at the HP. It just really is not there. Trying to get the spam through, but not happening. Deaths with his final few bullets will finish off Amor, and there's the flank. It looked good for a second. You know, Martinez was that first line of defense missing his shots, but he also didn't die.
Yeah.
So he buys that time, he buys that space, and the boys are there to back him up.
Exactly, yeah. You say, I mean, he may miss his shots, and it looks bad, but realistically, the fact he doesn't die, as you say, really wastes enough time for all the rotations to come in. And once
is probably why he's also missing the shots.
True.
I think the way that he was taking them
true.
Was that quarter of a second peak or whatever.
Yeah, and Movistar Riders, again, going for that re-aggression towards the top of ramp as well, just saying it's completely clear. I mean, gave them all the information they needed to know. And finally, they've broken the bank of Eternal Fire. They're down to Tech Nines now, and a Solitary Deagle. So, 5 rounds in a row is what it took. Eternal Fire, maybe sticking with if it ain't broke, don't fix it a little too long, because they've sort of gone for the same strategy to a day ramp that worked for them so well early on, but now they're going to have to try and do something with pistols instead. They've been great at some of these eco rounds recently. Gone straight through the smoke as well to try and keep himself alive a little while longer, and it's going to be an absolute wipeout. No kills at all coming through. For Eternal Fire, walks it with the Tech 9. One kill would be nice. He's getting spammed down. There goes the AWP. Looking for one more. Takes a second. And he's still relatively healthy as well. Can he get the gun? He can. The player rotating in from CT Connector, I should say, is Alex. And he's very, very low. Death is not holding that angle. He finds Alex. Or doesn't expect the humongous off angle. But still, two kills is okay. But as for the state of the game, six rounds in a row for Movistar is way more than okay. They're sick right now.
Really looking good. Yeah. I really didn't foresee. I just thought that we might have a bit of a concede, at least on this map, you know, or in the half. Flick to switch. 1-1 round, and there it is. There's that confidence. There's that camaraderie that we talk about, you know. They're such an emotional team. I think that
yeah,
it's really important for them to pick up some big rounds. And maybe in a way it's some weird bounce back mechanic, but you know, I just think that it's difficult for them when they're losing to get back in, but when they're winning, they can be really difficult to put away. And I think that's what we're seeing for Eternal Fire here. Lovely nade, great way to kickstart this round, and we'll see. The A attack now gonna look a bit weaker.
Yeah, once again, and they're gonna be trying to retake it with a flash again as well. And Woxix missed that first shot. He hasn't been taken down, but Alex is still holding a very tight line, and that's a smart angle to hold on the edge of the crane there. You can see, I think, the edge of their arms before they can see you. And Paz, oh, reloads at the worst time. Maybe Alex could have crept closer, but he still spams the right place. Paz, what a two amazingly impactful kills there. And that recovers around into a 4v3, but Movistar are going to continue to go aggressive. Another repeat coming in toward Gap at some point. Woxic needs to face his counterpart, Orpa Martinez, toward double stack, and he gets that win. 3v3, 35 seconds. In comes Antares, looking for a headshot, but now he's down low to 40 health as well. Pass 54, flashes in to come in to help out. Gets a bit of damage, but Major will trade it. And another chance in a 2v2. Oh, Martinez just switches off the angle as Paz crosses to the left. Should get the arm first and gets it. Now it's all Major 1v2, and Death catches him. And that's 7 in a row for Eternal Fire, and now 7 back in a row for Movistar Riders. Eternal Fire have hit the bumpers.
Kind of wild. And Eternal Fire have had a good couple rounds in here that looked winnable, that being one of them. And Movistar Riders just keep it together, don't panic, win the important fight. That one there, it was Martinez from headshot, you know, great peek from him. Always a risky one, but he knows it. He plays that angle every day of the week. But no, really solid stuff from Movistar Riders. And yeah, very surprising. And now we're like, who's going to get the 8th? We thought it was Eternal Fire 10 minutes ago, but now we're here. It looks like it should be Movistar Riders. Flash comes in. Mopoz going to lose his head. The flash ineffective. Uh-oh. Alex, nade in hand. Cannot get away. Can't find the frag. Just robbed. Immor left on 2. So certainly recoverable here. And obviously they're going to try and go for it because it's the final round of the bloody half. But the man power is against them here. It really is. Death, though, I like this flank. It's pretty fast.
It is, yeah. This is a great chance to recover this round now. I mean, Woxic and Immor, they've both taken so much damage for those opening two kills. Martinez going aggressive again as well. It's being faked out by Xantarez and actually hits the headshot. That is so dirty. Classic Xantarez peak pre-fires. Goodness me. Dinks Martinez straight through, but Death's play could still be big. Gets one. Now they know of his positioning, though, and in the end, he could not play trigger discipline any further, and that is some way to win the half for Xantarez and Major. Excellent recovery from Eternal Fire to get eight, but a great comeback from Movistar. We'll see how Vertigo will conclude after a quick break.
Amazing. Embrace your destiny, slay your enemy, raise a legacy. No more apologies, trust your abilities, gather the energies. Pull yourself back together and stay off track forever. Child of the nation, go seek redemption, time for salvation. Today is meant to be day of victory, time for history. Rebirth's a tendency, fight the entropy, channel your rivalry. You're praying for fortune to come. You're hearing the sound of the drums. It's too late to backtrack, but pack your bag now. Keep your feet on the road and stand up. You've got what it takes to fight back. Don't stop until you black out, 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 out. Stand up, up. You've got what it takes to fight back, back. Don't stop until you black out, out. Give all you got, show them how to make a miracle. Stand up, up, just go and just fight back, back. Don't stop until you black out, out. Give all you got, show them how to make a miracle. Go save your team, be a hero. Take home the cup, be a star. They're waiting for you, take aim, shoot your arrow. It's your time to shine, show them who you are. Stronger, gotta go faster. Gotta get better, gotta work harder. It's fight or flight now, getting it up now. Go with the mold, go for the goal. Lead up the stadium, you know how it's done. Stand up, up, just go what it takes. Fight back, back. Don't stop until you back out. Takes to fight back. Don't stop until you black out, out, out. What up? Welcome back. We're here. Half number two. It's swapped over, of course. Eternal Fire got seven. Then Movistar Riders got seven. Then Eternal Fire got the final round of the first half. Just to, you know, make it funny, I guess. But either way, we are indeed here. Movistar Riders on the harder T side. That's kind of the big thing here. We'll see. They're on five sets of Kevlar. Woxic, he spots them out. Doesn't find any heads. Imor also kind of the same deal. He's getting chased down. Ooh, nice one round the corner. Zantares and Wapsik, they've got to get through them. Just a massive bloodbath here. And, well, I'm not quite sure what the game plan was. Movistar Riders with a contact mid, but you're going into two, three angles at the same time? I don't know, man.
Yeah. Bit of a strange one there, I would say. And I mean, even though Eternal Fire did lose that streak of seven rounds in a row, I am confident in their CT side to be able to close this out. And if they're going to continue to hit headshots like that with rifles and SMGs, then, well, you're in good hands if you're an Eternal Fire supporter, that's for sure. So they've already messed up the run boost as well. Come on, let's get it done. Alex, don't fall off the map. Hey, he's fallen off the map. Deaths looks at him as if to say, sorry, mate. Maybe try again next time. See you later next round,
man. It does make me feel a bit better, you know. I love doing the old run boost. And I very, very rarely is it successful on the first time, you know.
Yeah.
Been kicked and banned a few times from games, you know, as well, you know, when you suicide too much.
Yeah, yeah. You know, as soon as they missed the first jump, I was like, don't try it again. Yeah, yeah, I just know what's going to happen. Bail. Please don't try it again. And then they didn't bail and they committed to it. But obviously, I mean, it looks stupid. At the end of the day, it's bad for their own money, but they were full eco, and it doesn't give an SMG $600. I know it sounds stupid. They clearly did not do that on purpose, but there is a silver lining to that situation.
Yeah, and I think when you've fallen off the map in front of thousands of people, you do have to look for the silver linings. Nice flash through the smoke here. It was going to be the first to fall. It is... It's kind of a weaker bonus from Eternal Fire. I'm not going to lie. Their weaponry really is not great across the board. They're being very, very cheeky for my money. And they've already lost the first player. Zantares got his smoke out.
Oh, Alex.
Yeah, there's gaps to be found. Oh, my goodness. And he gets two there. That's ridiculous. Major with the backup. And somehow they've wrestled back the man advantage.
That is just ridiculous. I mean, we all know that the Silence M4 is not the hardest spray in the world, but the fact that Zantares made that look so fast, so clean, and so accurate is ridiculous. Another two kills for him. He's up to 20 and 10 now. And look at this flank from Wapsik. He could be about to add more to his tally as well. Two players looking the wrong way ahead of him, and it's a perfect lineup as well. Of course it is for Wapsik. Eternal Fire win the bonus round as well with the SMGs. Everything's going their way.
Yeah, this is looking really, really solid here. Absolutely fantastic spot to get yourself in the early stages. So curious to see. They can keep it panning forwards.
Indeed. And even the best thing about that is that when you win your bonus round, you have a couple of SMGs in Famaster the next round. Well, it doesn't matter because you're playing against pistols again. So a great chance for Eternal Fire to clean a 12-7 here very quickly. At the beginning of this second half, and already Inmore wants some of these. He wants to eat some of these guys up for dinner with this MP9, and there's only one Kevlar, a set of Kevlar on Movistar on Alex, so should be pretty easy. And there we go. I don't believe in the caster's curse, but he's been destroyed by Mopoz, and that's only his fourth kill of the game as well. Maybe I should say that more often.
Yeah, I
know
it's that.
Get more.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
The
of course.
Players. All right, keep it coming, Trav. Keep.
He's not getting another
good
one.
Things about Mopoz.
He's not getting another one. No way.
All right. Well. We'll see. Maybe he won't, but there's certainly potential for someone else to chime in here. Woxic's going to take out Mopoz. So, yes, you are correct this time. No curse on that one. But we've got Paz on the backside. We'll see. Like I say, there's definitely potential for one or two more kills to open up here for Movistar Riders. They've really blown this round wide open, but a lovely smoke has hemmed them in. They're a bit trapped. They know exactly where it's at. So the info game is pretty good here for Eternal Fire.
Yeah, Paz is just being a nuisance there, and being a nuisance in a good way as well for Eternal Fire. That re-smoke just locks them out entirely, and they know it as well. Major and Paz, both with 8 kills, 9 deaths so far, and that's really all a team of Eternal Fire's quality needs to do. If your IGL's going -1 and your support player's going -1 while your big boy fraggers like Zantares, Wapsik, and Imor are doing really well, then that's basically... job done. You know, very rarely you'll see a round changed. But I'll tell you what about round changing. Davy G has control of sandbags, and he's got two kills with the picked up M4. And look at the health on Wapsik. 4 HP left. And he's in an impossible situation. Tap on the bomb to try and lure them out. But wary of Gap, but they're both in, going to be directly in front of him. Lineup will come in, but Alex takes the headshot. And what a round for Movistar Riders to win. How about that? Davy G stepping up with a recovered M4 to give Movistar an all-important eighth.
As you said, it's meant to be the gimme round. You've won your bonus. Now's a chance to make some cash. And I think maybe they, a bit like you, it's not as dangerous when you do it, but they're looking ahead. You know, they're thinking that this one's already in the bag.
Yeah.
And they lose sight of the round itself. Movistar Riders not messing around. Still here to play. And they're, again, not so far down that it's over, that it's kind of, you know, starting to feel like this is an unrecoverable and unclimbable hill. Loving it. Absolutely loving it. Movistar Riders, they are never down and out in this game. Davy G going to open up with a cheeky little frag onto him, or 5-on-4 straight out of the gate.
Yeah, it was an 8-7 half for these two teams. And funnily enough, it was 8-7 for the other two games we've got running as well. So symmetry across all the main ESL streams on this concurrent day of Pro League. That's nice to see. Keeps it all very interesting, very nicely poised. Of course, Eternal Fire still have a chance at making playoffs. They just need to win this game, either 2-0 or 2-1, and then have results go their way elsewhere. They're going to need Cloud9 to beat Team Liquid and Fury to beat EG. Either which way of it, they need Fury to beat EG 2-0. Otherwise, they have no chance, I believe. So it's definitely a slim opening, but if they can take it, then it would be one of the stories of the year.
Nice find from Martinez. Here we go. 5v3s and Tarez finally gets one in for Eternal Fire. Whoa, bro. He's in the molly. Maybe didn't need to move back from that position, but all the same, bit awkward for him. Major going to try and take a swing out. He does find a frag eventually. Paz on the backside. It is all crumbling. Flash comes in. It's ineffective, but Martinez with another missed shot. He's not quite on point this afternoon, is he?
No.
Zantarez will find deaths, and I think that's got to be the round. They know where he is. Only 10 seconds to go. He's onto the AK to desperately try and battle back, but it will not happen. And Eternal Fire immediately pick up number 12 back on the board.
Absolutely perfect from Eternal Fire. That looked rough, as you say. I mean, honestly, I really thought that Movistar were going to have that one, but Eternal Fire battle back, and once again, Zantarez getting an all-important kill to stop a sort of an aggressive push as well. And then when Martinez is stuck in towards sandbags with Paz on his own sandbags next to ramp, it's pretty much no way out. And of course, Paz then decides to reface as soon as he switches weapons. So awful timing for Martinez. And now, they're going to call a tactical timeout. Their second of four to try and discuss what they're going to do with this buy. Because Alex has got 5.6. Davy G has got 6.3. You can buy two AKs and maybe a Galil on Mopos. But other than that, it'll probably be pistols on Martinez and Death. So to choose to buy here would be a risky one. If you lose it, Eternal Fire would be 13-8, and then if it's a full investment, have pistols to face, and it could be 14-8. So I reckon you probably go for a hero AK or a full buy. And it looks like full buy is going to be the choice, and they're even going to get Martinez on an AWP as well. And let's see how that'll pan out, because I do feel like AWPing T-side Vertigo is one of the hardest maps.
Eternal Fire win this round, and they start to solidify their case of their own map pick in a relatively decisive fashion as well. This is big damage to kick off into round 21. Movistar Riders, no real answer. We don't have an aggressive, angry answer back. It seems like they're really just hoping someone gets a kill here on the widespread default, and they'll work off of that, but it's not coming. So what is the game plan here? We're almost a minute into the round, and no control, no kills, no damage even for Movistar Riders. They might even lose a player here. Deaths, the one with the weakest weapon, taken down by the in-game leader of Eternal Fire. That's a lot of info as well to boot.
Yeah.
So looking really damn good here for the CTs.
That's a really nice bit of play there for Major. I mean, there's been no mid-aggression from Eternal Fire really at all in this map so far. They didn't really focus it on T side, and they haven't really done much on CT either. So Major looking for information, finding the Tech 9 is a really important find that clears out that area completely. In the 34 seconds, they can't just retake that, so they're gonna have to make a call. Rotation's coming in toward B, and in fact, it's pulled a lot of rotations. There are 3 B and 1 mid right now, They've left the A bomb site almost in its entirety, and Movistar Riders are about to take it. Emil's rotating back in, but he's in a rough spot. They need to get taken out, but they've got their backs turned. Or Davigi has to look at sandbags. Maybe a flash coming in from Martinez as well to have to look away from. And that's two huge kills. And now 7 seconds to plant the bomb as well. Molotov can come in. That should deny it. And it's impossible. 3 seconds to go. If Telefi want to, they could even push and try and take down some of these players after time as well. But as it is, it will be two players to save for Movistar. And that denial from Imor was absolutely perfect.
Looking good now. 13-8. That is a much more decisive score, and I think this is what we talked about, what we were worried about a little bit. You got to keep the play going, the storyline going for sure, and obviously Riders, it was a nice recovery on the CT side, but you should be coming away with a bit more than that off of your CT side. It's the stronger, tougher end at the moment. Got to have a decent T side to boot, fair bit.
Yeah.
But it comes into play. It's kind of one of those default caster fallback type roles. Ooh, they're not on the T side, so they should be winning. Love this. No idea where he's getting shot from for a second there. Can't quite capitalize, unfortunately.
Yeah. There are...
They're pulling out a few sneaky moves.
There they are, yeah. There are a number of really dirty one-way smokes on Vertigo. There's one on A ramp, and there's a couple on the B stairs as well, which, honestly, as a T, you can see everything, but a CT can barely see you. It's pretty ridiculous, but if you're aware of that, you avoid them, and so far Eternal Fire have... So far, very clean game from everyone on the Eternal Fire roster, but we need to avoid these pistols. Now, Imor, he's just been tagged for 99 damage in one hit. That is enough to set anyone's alarm bells off.
This A bomb site looks so, so strong here. Like you said, big man's got to be careful, but here we go, Bogdan's. Well, he ain't quick with it. Not like Woxic. Nade, however, will finish off. And here's Major on the backside. Oh, God. Again, these flanks have been so prominent. They've been so good. 18 seconds to move in. Major gets another as Martinez was watching it. Thought that he could catch him, but he'd already made it through. Now just Davy G and Mopoz. It feels, in a sense, to save the map. Not out of the question, but as they continue to fall, maybe it is. Into just Mopoz. Takes down the low HP player.
Ooh.
Takes out another one. That's a hell of a shot. In for the 1v3. Paz with the tap.
Oh,
and Paz
yes.
with the fall. Mopoz with a huge, huge clutch. It will get Movistar Riders their ninth, and it keeps them in contention.
What a huge round. I thought Eternal Fire had that unlock. I mean, the way Major used that ramp smoke on the flank to then just push through the right-hand side of it, as he would have looked, completely fooled Martinez. And I thought as soon as that kill came in, especially when he reloaded on the crane position and then Woxic just comes in and helps out, I thought that was round over. But Mopal says no, and it's an insane clutch with the Galil. And that really keeps Movistar in this map, because if Eternal Fire won that round, it would have been 14-8 with them on good money. And at the moment, as it is, Eternal Fire are down to pistols off the back of that. But obviously, can you believe it? Xantara's already is hit back by just wallbanging the Elitark and taking Davy G out. So that's one kill already in Eternal Fire's favour in this one. Need to be careful, do Movistar. And now the kills are coming back in Eternal Fire's favour again. Xantara's with a second headshot. Facing his Deagle must be an absolute nightmare. And with Woxic finding one with his 5-7 as well, he gets a free AK upgrade. Just like that, it's switched again.
They just can't find the consistency on this T side. We've seen figure out where the wins are coming from. That's kind of one of the big things, right? You got a clutch in that previous round. It's great, but it's also rare. That's why they're so cool to watch. So if you can't figure out, if you don't have, you know, all right, cool, that worked. Here's what went a bit wrong. Maybe we can retweak it, or here's a good pocket round that we've got. They just can't figure out how to actually win rounds in conventional fashion. And that's exactly what we're seeing unfold here. Alex, now he's got a clutch up. Decent performer for this squad. Yeah, this looks too strong, doesn't it? The two of them. And there it is. He's not even considering it. Down he will go, and Eternal Fire with a cheeky impossible round of their own.
That was just, that's again just Xantara saying, hello, I can hit headshots, and I'm going to win the round basically all by myself. Woxix, obviously, his two kills are incredibly important. The one with the 5-7 to grab the AK and then play a dirty angle underneath the B stairs to get one more. And then, as you say, all Alex can really do is throw the AWP out the map and try and swing what was a pretty dirty double stack with Santara's and Major playing next to each other. And once again, of course, Santara's, even on a slightly strange angle, still hits an instant headshot. And that's a big recovery from Eternal Fire. This game could have very easily been back on again if Eternal Fire didn't hit straight back there, and already more damage done to the pistols in the following round by the main man himself.
Oh, Zantarez, nice pickup. He's hungry for more, isn't he? He wants his 30.
Yeah.
Eco rounds, this is where he thrives.
It was Woxic against Liquid, double 30s.
Hmm.
65 in two maps, I believe. Pretty insane. Looking for even more now to get up to 20. That's something at least. We're already on the big flank coming in, and Zantarez, he's increasing that kill count once again. Imor gets all the kills. Woxic comes on the flank saying, guys, I'm flanking. Oh, they're all dead. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, but, you know, it's the flank, the presence of the flank gives them the confidence to get aggressive. Because they
I know.
Backed up. So that's the unwritten. When you see your guy playing pit on Inferno, but the mid holder's getting all the kills, and then the pit guy's got like 5 kills, but he's only got like 2 deaths. It's because he's the anchor, he's the rock.
Exactly. You
know? No awards for guessing where I play on Inferno, but all the same. All the same, indeed. Someone's got to do it.
Are you a fellow B anchor then? I play B like on every map, so.
A lot of them, yeah. I'm not a massive support player, but I'm up there. Especially on the CT side, for sure.
Respect.
All right. What's happened here then while we've been talking? WG's there's a number 3
HP.
Of kills, a lot of damage. Here we go, Zantarez just dry through the smoke as we do. Yeah, it's
no
just
chance.
Falling apart, unfortunately, for the Riders, man. This T side, there just really isn't anything here.
No, I would agree with that. And 2 kills away for Eternal Fire to take their map pick. I said that I was confident in their Vertigo, considering the ridiculous form they've shown on it. They've beaten Furia, they've beaten Liquid on this map, and they're about to beat Movistar Riders as well. Zantarez goes one tap to get his 30th kill of the game, and he's even looking for that as well. WG is only 3 points of health, 1 bullet needed, and Immor's the one to take it. Eternal Fire comfortably take map 1, and that was as clean as a performance as you could possibly have hoped for when they need a victory to possibly have that slim chance of making playoffs.
Yeah, and those worries come in from Movistar Riders, man. The second half, just super, super flat. Sporadic rounds, hero plays getting them the rounds, and it's not fantastic signs, you know. It's maybe not a super preferred map for them, but